Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom. And Roy, thank you for being our slide guy. So we'll turn to the next slide. Vayafeh hayom Shabbat Shalom. Vayafeh hayom Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat, Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat, Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat, Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat Shalom. Vayafeh hayom Shabbat Shalom. Vayafeh hayom Shabbat Shalom. So Shabbat Shalom, everybody. We would like to welcome Nick and Sharon to bring in the lights of Shabbat. If you would like to light candles with them, that would be awesome. Otherwise, they will light the candles for us. So if we can focus on them, Roy, if you can find them, that would be beautiful. And we thank them in advance for honoring us by lighting the Shabbat candles. Right now, I just see, there they are. Good job. All right, bring in the light, you guys.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kiddushanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu lehadlik ner shel Shabbat.
Amen. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
Thank you so much. So let's get ready to welcome the Sabbath bride with some lechadodi. And we'll wait for Roy to flip the slide a little bit. With Lechadodi. There you go. Shamor. V'zachor b'dibur echad Hishmiyanu el hamichad Adonai echad u'shmor echad L'shem u'tivet v'alit chila L'chadodi likrat kala Pene Shabbat Nikavela Likrat Shabbat Lechu v'nelcha Ki hi mekor ha-bracha Mirosh mikedem nesucha If you're able to stand slowly to welcome the summer Sabbath bride. Bo'i v'shalom ateret ba'ala gam mitzimcha u'tzohra toch emune am segula bo'i chala bo'i chala lecha dodi likrat kala Pane Shabbat, neka bela. If you were standing, please be seated. The Sabbath bride is here. So we welcome the angels that visit us at Shabbat. Angels of peace. Shalom aleichem, malachei ha-shalom, malachei elyon. Mi-melech, malachei ha-mlachim, ha-kadosh baruch hu. Bo'achem le-shalom, malachei ha-shalom, Malachei Elyon, Mi Melech Malachei Hamlachim, Hakadosh Baruch Hu. Baruch Nil Boachem Shalom, Malachei Hashalom, Malachei Elyon. Melech Malachei Hamlachim, Hakadosh Baruch Hu. Boachem l'shalom, malachei ha-shalom, malachei ha-yon. Mi-melech malachei ha-mlachim, ha-kadosh baruch hu. Seidchem l'shalom, malachei ha-shalom, malachei ha-yon. Melech Malachei Hamlachim HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Say it chem again. Say it chem l'shalom Malachei HaShalom Malachei Ha'yon. Melech Malachei Hamlachim HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So I want to share with you a little bit about the focus of tonight's Shabbat. Of course, it is Shabbat. And for the early ones who came on early for the service, we shared one word about our week. And it went from serene, let me think, to frenetic. And I'm sure that if I asked you for a one word about your week, we would have quite a spread of thoughts. But Shabbat is here to remind us that we have a gift, and it is an eternal promise. It is a brit, it is a covenant between God and us, that as long as we open our hearts for Shabbat, as long as we make some effort to let Shabbat in, we are given this grace of rest. It's magic. I can't explain it, but when we bring it in, we can get rid of that slide, but when we bring it in, we're given some rest. So this Shabbat is actually a shift, this specific one in Jewish time. The Torah portion includes this week a cautionary note about the words that we say to one another, the promises we offer, and the importance of staying true to our word. This caution about the words that we say and the promises we make connects with the fact that tonight we enter a new moon, the new moon of Av. And it has been said that when we enter a new moon, the world, our lives kind of shake and break a little bit. By the way, there was an earthquake. There was a rumbling, and some of you have shared with me that you heard it. Yes, when there's a new moon, things shake up a little bit. And the new moon is the moon of Av. This month, the theme of Av commemorates the destruction of the temples in Jerusalem. And yet with that hardship, we are aware of our endurance, of our ability to rise up and to manage when those things such as destruction have occurred. Some Jewish scholars suggest that the destruction of the temples was a result primarily of the Babylonians and the Romans. Others suggest that the destruction of the temples in Jerusalem was connected to a weakening of our own spirits due to infighting amongst ourselves. However we view it, this Shabbat will be about looking at the power of our words and how we use them with one another and what it means to give an oath. The topic of integrity of speech is as relevant today as it was in the past, which makes Judaism a timeless spiritual path. So I want to welcome all of you, and I want to welcome our friends from Beit Haverim. Thank you so much for being with us as we enter this Shabbat of words, of promises, and our integrity. Mark Twain said, if you tell the truth, you don't have to remember anything. As we turn to the song Emet, Emet means truth. And the words are Emet, Atahu Rishon, truth, you are first. V'atahu Acharon, and you are also the last. Umi Baladecha, and beside you, Ein Lanu Melech, we have no ruler or redeemer. And it goes like this. In a minute. Emet, Emet, Emet Atahu Rishon. Emet, Emet, Emet Atahu Acharon. Baladecha ilanu melech, melech goel umoshiga. Umi baladecha ilanu melech, melech goel umoshiga. And then we say emet a whole bunch of times like this. Emet, 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 atahu rishon. Emet, 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 atahu acharon. Umi baladecha ilanu melech, melech goel umoshiga. Umi baladecha ilanu melech, melech goel umoshiga. So emet and truth and keeping our word will flow through our service. And now I'd like to invite us to turn to the Chatzi Kaddish, and we'd like to invite Eden Cohen, who is studying for his bar mitzvah. He came back from his first time at Camp Newman and had a fabulous time. Thumbs up if that's true. Right? And will you lead us, please, in the Chatzi Kaddish?
Itkadal v'itkadash shemei rabba. Bealmadi vrach hirte vialichmachute, Bechayechon uviomechon
uviomechon
uviomechon Israel. Ba agala uvizman kari, vimru amen. Yeheshme rabba mevorach, la alam ula meyamaya yit barach. Vit barach, vishtavach, vit paar, vitrama, vit nase. Vita dar, vita le, vita la, shmeide kudasham brihu, le e la min kobirchata vashirata, tush bachata venech, emata da mi rambelma, vimeru amen.
Thank you so much, Eden. And we'll hear from you later for Viahavta. If you're able to stand and face east, join me in the barhu. La 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 la. La 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 Adonai Roy, dear, if you could help people mute themselves just so that we can hear a little bit better. So we talk about the change of seasons from hot to hotter. But we also know that with the change of seasons come delicious tomatoes. And in the case of Holly and Bob, grandchildren coming to splash in their pool. And so we roll into dark, roll into light, and bless the seasons as they come and shift and return. Roll into dark, roll into light. Night becomes day, day turns to night. Roll into dark, roll into light. Night becomes day, day turns to night. Borei Yom Valayla, Olel Amid Nechoshef, Olel Amid Nechoshef, Bechoshef Mipnei Yor. Roll into dark, roll into light. Night becomes day, day turns to night. Roll into dark, roll into light. Night becomes day, day turns to night.
In our Torah portion, it says, if you make a vow to the eternal or take an oath imposing an obligation on yourself, you shall not break your pledge. You must carry out all that has crossed your lips. Sorry about the typo. And the teaching says, if you make a promise, we're supposed to keep it. However, the text uses two very different terms here to make its point. Neder is translated as vow, and it's generally used to represent a promise to do something. I vow to give $1,000 to tzedakah. Shvua, on the other hand, is generally translated as an oath, implying a promise to abstain from something. I swear to stop gossiping. In each case, as soon as it is uttered, the promise in Judaism is considered binding. In Psalm 119, it said, your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path.
Amcha ahavta, Torah u'mitzvot, chukim u'mishpatim, otanu limadta, otanu limadta. Hakein Adonai Eloheinu b'shochbeinu, kumeinu nasiach b'chukecha, v'nismach b'divrei Toratecha, u'mitzvotecha le'olam va'ed. Ki hem chayeinu, Ve'orech yameinu Uvahem negei yoma v'layla Negei yoma v'layla Ve'ahavatcha al tasir Bimenu le'olami Baruch ata Adonai Ohev amo Yisrael Ohev amo Yisrael If you are able to stand with me, cover your eyes or sit, whatever is most true for you in this moment. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Eden, would you help us with Ve'ahavta, please?
Ve'ahavta et Adonai Elohecha b'chol levavcha u'b'chol nafshecha u'b'chol me'odecha v'hayu hadvarim ha'ele asher anochi mitzavecha Hayom alavavecha, v'shinantam levanecha, v'dibartabam, v'shivtecha b'veitecha, uvletecha v'aderech, uveshoch b'cha uvkumecha, ukshartam le'ot ayadecha, v'hayu letovtachot b'neinecha, uchtavtam amezuzot b'eitecha uvisharecha. Laman tizkeru ve'asitem et kol mitzvotai bitem kedoshim le'lohechem. Ani Adonai Elohechem. Asher hotzei tietchem me'eret mitzrayim lihiyot lachem le'lohim. Ani Adonai Elohechem. Adonai Elohechem. Amen.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Joel Shapiro, would you please read Love Your God? And Roy, if you could find, there you did. You just need to unmute yourself.
Love your God with every heartbeat, with every breath, with every conscious act. Keep in mind the words I command you today. Teach them to your children. Talk about them at work. Whether you are tired or you are rested, let these words guide the work of your hands. Keep them in the forefront of your vision. Do not leave them at the doorway of your house or outside your gate. These words are reminders to all of my mitzvot, so that you can be holy for your God. I am Adonai, your God. I let you out of Egypt to become your God. I am Adonai, your God.
Thank you.
Mihamocha ba'ili madonai, mikamocha neda bakodesh, nora tahilot, ose osefele, who is like you Adonai? Who is like you, Adonai? When Moses and the children crossed the sea, they sang to you these songs of joy. Who is like you, Adonai? Mihamocha ba'elim Adonai, mihamocha ne'edar ba'kodesh.
Oh,
Malchutecha ra'uvanecha, bokei hayam lifnei Moshe u'Miriam, ze'elianu ve'emru Adonayim loch le'olam va'ed. V'ne'amar kifadan et Yaakov u'galo miyad chazak mimenu, baruch ata Adonai ga'al Yisrael. Baruch atah, atah Adonai ha'porei sukkat, shalom. Shalom aleinu ve'akol lamo Yisrael. Baruch atah, atah Adonai ha'porei sukkat, shalom. Shalom aleinu ve'akol lamo Yisrael. Ve'ayirushalayim ve'hakol amo, ve'ayirushalayim shalom. Baruch atah, atah Adonai ha'porei sukkat shalom. Shalom aleinu ve'hakol amo Yisrael. Shalom aleinu ve'akol amo Yisrael.
In Numbers chapter 32, verse 24, V'hayatzeh ugdorot sonechem lachem arim v'tapchem banu ta'asu mipichem. Build cities for your little ones and folds for your sheep, and what has proceeded from your mouth, you should do. When you vow a vow to God, do not delay paying it, for God has no pleasure in fools. Pay what you vow. It is better that you should not vow than you should vow and not pay. Let not your mouth lead you into sin. And do not say before the messenger, whoops, it was a mistake. I added the whoops.
Vishamru v'nei Yisrael et ha-shabbat. Lasot et ha-shabbat ledorotam. Berit olam. Sheshet yamim masa Adonai et hashamayim ve'et haaretz uvayom hashvi'i shavat shavat vayinafash shavat shavat vayinafash Shabbat, Shabbat, Vayinafash.
As we prepare for the tefillah, this teaching is in Mishkan Tefillah, our prayer book, which before you know it, my friends, we will be back in our synagogues, Beit Haverim in yours and Beth Shalom in ours, looking at those words in our sacred Siddur. For now, we lift those words from the Siddur where it says, pray as if everything depended on God and act as if everything depended on you. So please stand if you're able and join me in the tefillah.
Adonai sifat ha-tiftach Ufi agita hilatecha Adonai, open up my lips that my mouth may declare your praise. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu ve'lohe avoteinu v'imoteinu, Elohe Avraham, Elohe Yitzchak, Elohei Yaakov, Elohei Sarah, Elohei Rivka, Elohei Rachel, Elohei Leah, Ha'el Hagadol Hagibur Vahanura, Elohim, Gomel Chasadim Tovim, Bekonei Hakol, Zocher Chasdei Avot Ve'Imahot, ומביא גאולה לבני בניהם למען שמו ביבה. מלך חוזר ומושיע ומגן. ברוך אתה אדוני, מגן אברהם ועזרת שרה. אתה גיבור לעולם אדוני, מחיי מתים אתה, רב להושיע. מוריד אתה, מחכה לחיים בחסד. Mechaye meitim berachamim rabim, somach noflim verufech olim, umatir asurim, umekayem emunato, lishenei afar, micha mocha bar gevurot, umido melach, melech memit umechaye, ומצמיח ישועה, ונאמן אתה להחיו מתים. ברוך אתה, אדוני, מחיי המתים. אתה קדוש ושמך קדוש, וקדושים בכל יום ילו חסלע. ברוך אתה, אדוני, האל הקדוש.
Please be seated. If you are standing. And this idea of lifting our hands, you know, saying, dear God, this is as present as I get. Please accept me where I am and accept my prayers on this Shabbat.
Ritzei Adonai Eloheinu Me'amecha Yisrael Utefilatam Yahava Tekabel Utahiliratzon Amir Avodat Yisrael Yisrael Amecha Baruch atah Adonai She'otecha levadecha v'yira
So, dear friends, when we go outside of our houses when it cools down a little bit, I know, not enough, but it will. Either tonight or tomorrow or the next night, you will see that beautiful thin sliver of a new moon. And that's the new moon of Av. And there is a blessing that said, praised are you, Holy One of Blessing, who created, in Hebrew, bara, the skies with a word, and all heaven's host with the breath of the mouth. Our Creator gave them appointed times and roles, and they never missed their cues, doing their Creator's konam, bidding with gladness and joy. God is the true Creator, Poel, who acts faithfully and has told the moon to renew itself. It is a beautiful crown for the people carried by God from birth, Yisrael, who will likewise be renewed in the future in order to proclaim the beauty of their creator, Yotzram, for God's glorious majesty. Praised are you who renews new moons. And this, my friends, is a little bit of a chart where I'd like you to take a look, if you would, because it's actually the year. And if you see that, look where Passover is. It's around 1 o'clock. Nisan, Iyar, Sivan.
those Passover and then the counting of the Omer and then Shavuot. And then we enter into Tammuz, which we just had. And now we're in where it says five, the month of Av. Now, Av, this period of time from Tammuz all the way up to Elul is kind of a more somber time. And let me share with you a little bit about the month of Av as we're here. Av is the fifth month. It's considered the fifth month of the Jewish calendar. It always falls around the same time of July and August. The constellation or the mazal of Av is Leo or Aryeh, the lion. In Hebrew, Av is spelt with an aleph and a vet, the first two letters of the Hebrew alphabet. It commemorates the destruction of the temples, as I mentioned earlier. And it also teaches that the messianic era will come through the suffering or the hardship of those destructive times. In Av, our mourning turns to celebration as we move from the sadness of losing the past as the destruction of the temples to the hope of a brighter future. Now, there are a couple notable events that happen in Av that I want to share with you. The ninth of the month of Av is called Tisha B'Av, the ninth of Av, and it's considered, and for many Jewish people, it's a day of fast, marking the destruction of both temples, as well as a seriously bad karma day for the Jewish people. So many very, very difficult things happened on that day. And it is observed by reading from the Book of Lamentations, and in Israel in particular, it's a very powerful time. On the 15th of the month of Av is called Tu B'Av, and that is considered a festive holiday. It's considered kind of like Valentine's Day for the Jewish people. The young women of Israel, according to the Talmud in Tractate Ta'anit, it says that the women of Israel used to dress in white and go out in the fields, and the young men would follow them there. I'm sure that we can expand that to all kinds of genders and fluidity and what is desire. But the origin and the meaning of Tu B'Av customs are unknown. It's considered maybe a midsummer festival filled with dance and romance. And it's when the full moon is happening. So just keep that in mind when you see the full moon of this month. Blow kisses wherever you want to. And let me think what else. And then there's one other thing. The rabbis named this month, the month of Av, Menachem Av, the comforter of Av, because after Tisha B'Av, we begin seven special weeks of Haftorah where the prophets offer us solace and hope. So here is a prayer for the month of Av from Marcia Falk. And Holly, would you please read this in a loud voice if you're there? Unmute though.
Okay. May the month of Av be a month of blessings, blessings of goodness, blessings of joy, peace and kindness, friendship and love, creativity and strength, serenity, fulfilling work and dignity, satisfaction, success, and sustenance, physical health and radiance. May truth and justice guide our acts and compassion temper our lives, that we may blossom as we age and become our sweetest selves. May it be so.
Thank you. Thank you. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable to you, Adonai. Adonai Tzuri, which means God is my rock. Adonai Tzuri. Adonai Tzuri Vekoali. Adonai Tzuri, Adonai.
Suri, Adonai, Suri, Vegali. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable to you, Adonai, Adonai Tzuri, Adonai Tzuri, Adonai Tzuri, Vegoali, Adonai Tzuri, Adonai Tzuri, Adonai Suri Feko Ali.
Oh, let's go back for a sec. There you go. There we go. So this week's Torah portion includes that strong passage about honesty. And it's not honesty in general, but a specific kind of honesty where a person gives their word, such as I swear or I promise. These words of pledge when sworn upon something of great sanctity, like God or a sacred text or upon our heart, are meant to cement that the words we say are to be believed. So since words matter, since promises matter, since vows matter, since contracts matter, since covenants matter, Judaism is extremely cautious about trivializing them. We are to avoid swearing to God, avoid promising, unless we are sure that it is what we want and believe is right to be doing. When we make an oath or give a vow and break it, we uncork our integrity and let it run out all over the street. The reason why we have kol nidre, which, you know, kol nidre v'yasare, it's a way of releasing us from the vows that we have made that we weren't able to keep. So when we need to break a vow, in Judaism, you know, we're human. We make mistakes. We give our word. We can't keep it. We ritualize it. There's actual ceremonies that we do that help us mindfully untangle ourselves from vows that we cannot keep. But I want to tell you a story. And it's a story from the 4th century about a Talmudic sage known as Rava. And he told the story about a town called Kushta, which, by the way, I looked up the origin of the word Kushta, and for some reason it has to do with the word Cinderella. I don't know, we could talk about that later. But Kushta, a place, according to one version of the story, no one ever aged, no one ever died, and no one knew exactly why. But a corrupt king learned about the town of Kushta, and enticed by the prospect of eternal life, dispatched his wisest counselor to discover Kushta's secret. So the counselor made the journey to that far-off place. And there he noticed the trees, their branches, low to the fruit with apricots, and everywhere people were eating them. I found the secret, he said to himself. So he collected a basket full of the golden apricots, returned to the king, who promptly imprisoned him, not wanting anyone else to share the gifts from Kushta. Then the king began to eat the apricots, and then he ran to the nearest mirror to watch himself grow younger, but instead his hair turned white immediately. Furious, he had the counselor executed. The king sent another messenger to Kushta to learn the town's secret. The messenger noted that the inhabitants drank water only from a particular stream. I know the secret, he thought, and he filled a flask with the magic water. When he returned home and presented the bottle to the king had him locked up,
And standing before his mirror, the king drank from the bottle of magic water from Kushta and watched himself grow older still. This messenger, too, was put to death. At last, the king declared, "I will go to Kushta myself." And so he departed in his royal chariot, bringing with him a big bag of gold. When the carriage passed through Kushta's gates, the town's inhabitants gathered around it with great bewilderment. The king emerged, and lifting his bag of gold so all could see, he said, "I will reward anyone who can tell me why none of you ever grow old." The inhabitants looked at one another in astonishment. None of them knew the answer. Again, the king declared, "I promise you, I will reward you if you tell me what makes your town so different from any other." At that, one citizen stepped forward and said, "In our tongue, Kushta means truth. And in Kushta, we speak only the truth. That's what makes us different." Having revealed Kushta's secret, the individual then approached the king for the promised reward. But the corrupt king, seeing no value in this information, shoved the man away. The townsfolk cried out, We told you our secret. We want our gold." The king brushed them aside, climbed back into his chariot, laughing, and headed home. Strangely, by the time he reached his own realm, the king was no longer alive. But what happened in Kushta was stranger still. The citizens who had never aged before suddenly began to. For when the king had broken his word in the town called Truth, the trust of the entire community was shattered. And today, when anyone visits Kushta, they will find it no different than any other place they've traveled. Commenting on the story, Rabbi Fred Reiner writes, "We too live in a time of broken trust, a time of secret truths and public falsehoods, when truth of even our leaders is manipulated and massaged and masked and packaged and spun. And make no mistake, just like the people of Kushta, we too are diminished by that. What happens in the halls of government sets the tone for our national discourse. And David Brooks put it like this: we grow tolerant of corruption and wind up too tired or morally numb to do anything." So there is a powerful lesson in all of this. In the eyes of Torah, integrity and honesty are not commands, but rather they are a way of life. The sacredness of our word should be woven into the fabric of our being, just as it is woven into the many stories and laws of Torah. So on this Shabbat, on the first day of the month of Av, with the Parsha Maaseh Matot, we are summoned, all of us, back, 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 back to the path of honesty and integrity, of self-recognition and redemption. May each of us hearken to the call, and our beloved country as well. And together we say, Amen. At this point, dear friends, we open our hearts to Misha Berach, to praying for ourselves or for people that we know who are in need of healing. We have decided tonight to open this up to gallery, if you can do that for us, Roy, so that we can see one another. And if you could please say the names of your loved ones out aloud so we can see you and pray for them together, all together.
Richard Shake.
I have an idea. Why don't we raise our hand and then you'll see that person. Esther Verano. Mary.
Alex Droffin.
Nick.
Hansuk Park.
Bob. You're on mute.
Meredith Rosenberg.
Lucy.
Richie Chaykin.
Roy.
Lean Casella.
Merrill.
Richard Shader.
Elise.
Marion Parnes and Lisa David.
Heidi, dear.
Bill McDonald's, Tony Maynard, and Stanley Carter.
We pray for Judy Tomsky, Joel Shapiro.
Sylvia Wexler.
Thank you. Karen and Eric, yes?
Harriet Walters and Rosemary Watnick.
Barbara Feinberg.
If there's anyone else, please feel free to share the names or offer them in your heart or put them in a chat. It's your prayer. These are some of the names from Beit Chavirim. We pray for their refuah shlema, a complete healing.
Misha Beirach Avotenu Mekor HaBracha Laimotenu. May the source of strength who bless the ones before us help us find the courage to make our lives a blessing, and let us say, Amen. Misha Beirach Imotenu Mekor HaBracha Lavotenu. Bless those in need of healing with refuah shlema, the renewal of body, the renewal of spirit, and let us say, Amen.
Would like to invite Merrill to share what's up at Beth Shalom. And I would so welcome anyone from Beit Chavirim who has some announcements to share. Please know that we welcome you. And Merrill, if you would unmute, please.
Okay. Now I have to, I see. Mute myself. Okay, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. I was trying to be in two places because I didn't realize you could bring up the announcements. Okay. First of all, hi, Shabbat Shalom. It's wonderful to be with our Beth Chavirim friends as well as our CBS friends. So tomorrow for us, Torah study is at 9 a.m. On Tuesday at 7 p.m., we'll be having the special board meeting to discuss the new Terumah model. And everyone is invited and encouraged to come with any questions they might have. Choir rehearsal is on Wednesday from 7 to 9. We still need baking volunteers for the food fair. And if you are so inclined, first of all, thank you. Secondly, contact Robin Ash, Lynn Snyder, or Carol in the office to sign up. Next Friday will be the first lay-led service of the summer, and it's also our social justice Shabbat. It's going to be led by Robin Ash and Lucy Ezrelou. Lucy will be speaking about The Social Dilemma, the movie some of you may have seen, may still want to see, and the effects of social media on society. And then we're going to be having a social justice panel discussion on Sunday at 4 p.m., which she will be moderating with other panelists. Let's see. Chang Hong, the assistant professor at Cal State, Rick Snyder, who's our own congregant and media consultant, and Lindsay Susskind, who's the director of customer success. And lastly, tonight is our last service with Rabbi Nancy for the summer before she takes her well-deserved break. So Shabbat Shalom to everyone.
Thank you very, very much, Meryl. Thank you. Is there someone from Beit Chavirim that would like to share some announcements, like what time is your Torah study? We would be happy to have you share.
Torah study tomorrow at 9 a.m. and our regular Shabbat morning service at 10 o'clock, being led by Rabbi Cynthia Hoffman. So that's what we've got going this weekend.
Great. Wonderful. Well, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And now I just want to, let's move toward Aleinu. And if you're able to stand, please join us, or stay where you are, and please join us also. Aleinu l'shabach ladon hakol, latet gedula l'yotzev reshit, shelo asanu kigoye haratzot, velo samanu kimishpachot adama, shelo sam chelkenu kahem, vegor aleinu kechol hamonam, Anachnu korim umishtachavim umodim lifnei melech mache hamlachim hakadosh baruch hu shehu noteh shamayim veyoser haaretz umoshev yikara bashamayim mima'al ushchinatu zo begov hemeromim hu Eloheinu einod Memakenu afuzulatom, kakatu betorato viadatahayom, the hashivota elevavecha, ki Adonai hua Elohim, bashamayimi ma'al, ve'al ha'aretz, ve'al ha'aretz, mihitachadenod. Vane'emar v'chaya Adonai l'melech al kol haaretz b'yom ha'hu, b'yom ha'hu yehe Adonai echad u'shma, u'shma, u'shma echad. Please be seated. Roy, I'm not sure what's happened to my screen, but I'm not able to see anything. I don't know why. It just changed. So I am going to ask you, please, to read the names, because I don't have them. They are not on my screen any longer.
Sure. So these are the 11 months Kaddish from CBH. Susie Nachmanoff, mother of David Nachmanoff. Gary Kaplan, the brother of Roy Kaplan. Judith Stone, the mother of Douglas Stone. Charles Radding, the brother of Pearl Carpenter. Ruth Tausig, mother of Beth Tausig.
Really?
Albert Firestein, mother of Kenneth Firestein. Herbert Gelb, the grandfather of Abigail Fruitsa, Wes Perlman, friend of Benjamin Katz, Reuben, aunt of Doug Stone, Rachel Leonard, mother Dael Newberry, John Wagner, father of Katrina Wagner, Jake Lee, son of Rich and Christy Lee, Dean Pepper, friend of Rabbi Greg, and Ellie Goldman, mother of Mark Goldman. And these are the yard sites for this week at CBH. Sam Al-Hadef, grandfather of Eric Crane. Rachel Levitt, daughter of Elise Parnes. Earl Levin, mother of Roy Levin. Monica Motes, mother of Marcia Motes Chen. Salman Fram, father of Daphna Fram. And Dick Shirley, father of Carol Shirley.
I just, Lily just fixed my screen. I want to also add the name of Janice Green, aunt of Michael Bobel. From Congregation Beth Shalom, those who have passed within the 11 months, Billy Jenkins, Nancy Ann Sutter, Charlie Hilty, Marie Fink, Maria Pellegrino Eisner, Sheila Sugarman, Nancy Norton Fleischman, Raul Saavedra, Leroy Davis, Sarah Everard, Christine Verano, Ann Kilcrease, Gloria Dottie, Susan Blum, Jerome Marvin Hyman, Ivan Krakowski, Michael Salmon, Frank Ketchell, Patrick Ashley, Alfredo Laniado, Beatrice Massad, Dean Myrtle, Alberto Arab Cohen, Kathy Klein, Samuel Alberta Apisoa. And I want to make sure that the names of Carol Hepper, Stanley Stern, Florenciano Carvajal are mentioned as well. We remember the yard sites from Beth Shalom, Michael Blast, father of Estelle Tansy, Emmy Bromet, sister of Carrie Cohn, Ethel Lang, grandmother of Heidi Maffitt, Lionel Margot, grandfather of Robin Salter, Sarah Merker, mother of John Merker, Sheila Harfield Parrish, wife of Scott Parrish, Chaim Wiseman, father of Elion Eisner. Zichronam Livracha, may all their memories be for a blessing. As we stand as one community, please feel free to unmute yourself so that we can hear, despite that it's a cacophony, the energy of one another. Yitgadal. Thank you all. You know, there's something very beautiful about just hearing ourselves, and you know, as that prayer concludes, when I hear Ose Shalom, Ose Shalom, Ose Shalom, like it's just so, hearing all of us wherever we are asking for peace is very, very beautiful. So if you have any fruit of the vine, or you want to imagine that you're drinking fruit of the vine, or you'd like to share some of my fruit of the vine, any way you slice it, L'chaim, may you be blessed. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, Borei pri hagafen.
Baruch Atarnai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Asher Kedishanu Mitzvotav Ratzavanu, V'Shabbat Kodesho V'Avav Ratzon Hinchilanu, Zikaron L'Maaseh V'Reishit, Ki Hu Yom Techila L'Mikra'ei Kodesh, Zecher L'Tziat Mitzrayim, Kivanu V'Acharta V'Yotanu Kidashta, Mikohamim, V'Shabbat Kodeshecha V'Ahava U'Ratzon Hinchaltanu Baruch Ata Adonai Mekadesh HaShabbat
B'chaim. Okay, before you try, oh, you flipped. Okay, I know you're looking at this and you're having a lot of feelings about it. This is what I want to say. Every week, Julie Seltzer, who is an artist and Torah scribe, bakes a challah depicting an aspect of this week's of the week's Torah portion. So this one says in the Hebrew, Ish ki neder neder la, b'chol hayaseh mipni ya'aseh. When we take a vow, whatever leaves our mouth, we must do. So this challah is meant to look like a mouth. And I think that it does. And you know what, you guys? I am so looking forward to, and oh, I gotta say, because we often want to say things, I know I do, enthusiastically about what I'd love to do, there's a Jewish tradition of saying, Bli Neder, without a vow, without a vow. So I'd like to say that I'm thinking after the high holidays, I want to make, you know, I make challah every week. I would like to make it with a message from the Torah portion. So I look forward to sharing that with you when we get back together. But in the meantime, check out that challah. And now let's go gallery, if we can. All right. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Hamotzi Lechem Min Haaretz. Amen. B'teavon, everyone. Shabbat Shalom. A big shout out to Rick, who helped me make the slides, and to Roy for doing such a great job. To all of you, Shabbat Shalom. Please attend these wonderful Leiled services. They're awesome. You will grow. You will love it. So please support each other. Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat, 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 Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat, 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 Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat, 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 Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat, 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 Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat, 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 Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat Shalom, everybody. Have a great, peaceful, stay cool, stay hydrated.
Shabbat Shalom, Lucy. Shabbat Shalom, Julie. Thank you for joining us. Shabbat Shalom, Joel. Shabbat Shalom, Nick. Oop, he's gone.
I love it when you do this.
What? Maria? I never saw more Maria. Shabbat Shalom, Maria.
Shabbat Linda. Shabbat Shalom, Lucy. Did you get everybody? All right.
No, Jean. Shabbat Shalom, Jean.
Jean. All right. Kathy. Linda, thank you so much for joining us. Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat Shalom, everybody. Be well.
Enjoy your holiday.
Thank you very much. But there's Torah study tomorrow. Okay, take care, everybody.
All right.
Shabbat Shalom.
Good night.